Guys, Icon Whisper here with another video game sale ramble. So to start off this episode, we have the Humble Bundle Best of 2017, which I don't think means games that came out in 2017. It just means, I guess, the best ones that they handpicked out of bundles that they had in 2017. So in the $1 tier, you get Five Nights at Freddy's Sister Location. So that is a horror type game if you are not familiar with it. I haven't even seen this one per se. Doesn't look like it shows any gameplay, but if it's anything like first couple, which I assume it is, you're kind of like a night employee person who's watching like security cameras of the place, and some of the like animatronic things get up and move around, and you have to keep an eye on that and shut doors for your own safety. Then we have Goat Simulator, which definitely did not come out in 2017, but it's an interesting little physics-based game where you play as a goat walking around messing stuff up. And I guess this is just the base game. I'm not sure if the expansions were DLC or free LC, but they had quite a few, like an MMO type one, where it was, I'm pretty sure it's still like just single player, but they set it up with classes and things like that. So you have a Goat Simulator, and then Hacknet, which I have mentioned before, but it's if you like programming or Linux or anything like that, it might be interesting to you. If not, then it'll probably be pretty boring to you. It's kind of like a hacking simulator. But you're using like scripts and things to hack their ports and get around and open SSH and stuff on them, and then you're just using like Linux commands to get around their file system and stuff like that. So yeah, if you are interested in that, it is in the $1 tier. $5.75 currently, and it's more than the average, is Verdun, which I really enjoy. I think it's a cool game. It's set in World War One, so it's, and it's a lot more realistic and maybe difficult than Battlefield One, where Battlefield One is just all about the graphics and the explosions and fast-paced running around and not really historically accurate weapons. Everyone in Battlefield One has like an automatic weapon or a semi-auto, which just was not the case. So it's more realistic. Everyone goes down in like one shot. Most people have action weapons, but it's a very cool game. I really enjoy it. I might put a video up of it soon if there's any interest in it. I have a lot recorded. I've done a lot of videos in the past on my other channel, but it's very cool. I saw on their Steam page they were like planning a historical like reenactment battle you could sign up for on the 18th of this month. That seemed kind of cool. And they have a another game out, Dannenberg. That's also very cool. I believe that's still early access. They also have Sins of a Solar Empire Rebellion, which is like your huge real-time strategy type space game where you're colonizing worlds and building fleets and stuff. It's all just a cinematic dramatization. Is pretty cool if you enjoy strategy games. I haven't played Rebellion, but I played just the base, Sins of a Solar Empire. There is Death Road to Canada, randomly generated road trip simulator, which, why are you playing as a dog? Oh wow, he's picking up a car. So I don't really know how this game works, but it kind of reminds me of like Oregon Trail, except with better graphics and much better combat. It's pretty fun, actually. Up to 500 zombies can hunt you down at a time. Yeah, that seems. That seems pretty fun. I hadn't seen much about that game, but I've definitely seen the name. And there's like a simulator where you. You're drilling for oil, and you have to like make the little town, and it seems interesting. Never played that one personally, but seems kind of fun. And then for $10 or more, you get Dead by Daylight, which is a multiplayer game only, where there's four survivors. Trying to escape, and one kind of like serial killer murder type thing, and you're like reenacting a horror movie essentially. So, that is the Best of 2017 bundle. They also have a VR sale at Humble Bundle going on right now. So 30% off Doom and Fallout 4 VR. Gorn is a lot of fun. I've mentioned that before. It's like a Colosseum type simulator type thing where lots of weapons, lots of enemies, and you can really do anything. I played that at a friend's house, and I went through a couple levels just punching people instead of using the levels, and or you can like up and use them as shields or throw them. It's a lot of fun. Serious Sam. I watched somebody play the Rick and Morty one, and that seemed pretty funny. I've heard great things about a super hot VR, where you feel like you're in the Matrix, and like time only moves when you move, so you gotta like stop and freeze and then do something real quick, like pick bullets out of the air and throw them back, or crazy stuff. Yeah, there's a lot of cool things here. I'm actually really interested in getting a 5 or something. I wasn't really before, but they've come out with some pick up, maybe do some videos with or something. Definitely be fun to play. So if you have like an Oculus Rift or a Vive, then there's definitely some things on sale right now for you. Same people, but if it's not, it definitely looks inspired. So that seems like it could be interesting. Oxenfree, I've heard the name of, but not actually seen. But I have no idea what this is like. Kind of like, yeah, supernatural thriller. Mushroom 11 is like a puzzle game where you're moving your weird mushroom blob to solve different puzzles. Another lost phone Lara story. A game about exploring the social life of a young woman whose phone you have just found. That sounds creepy. Just interacting with the phone. That's creepy. All right, that's weird. Party Hard, which I think is you have to at this party secretly, I guess. I saw Zane Anders play this and it seemed really weird. Yeah, just took out people with a bull. Alright, and then there's Death Road to Canada again, except for your phone. And here's a couple games I thought looked interesting and I was looking at. So this looked like a mix of the game Kingdom and just a side scroller action RPG. So you're exploring and looking for loot and leveling up and stuff. But you're also upgrading a little town full of dwarves and rescuing them. So it seemed kind of interesting. So I thought I'd mention that one. Regions of Ruin. And then of course there is Vermintide 2 coming out at some point this year. You can pre-order it, but just I hope the graphics are really this good because they look really amazing. And in addition to Skaven, there are Chaos Warriors. So it should be really awesome. Looking forward to that. It's 10% off for pre-ordering it, and this is the collector's edition, which would give you exclusive pre-order beta prior to launch, and you get one DLC, Death on the Reich, for free. So, and I guess you get the soundtrack and some skins and wallpapers, I guess. And one exclusive levels are hard and weird, but you're just doing like normal everyday tasks and not trying not to be found out that you're actually an octopus. Carmageddon. Some of the old Gothic series games are here for fairly cheap. System Shock 2. The old Turok games. Dang, that's going way back. Don't Starve is $3.74. And some of the DLC are on here. Shipwrecked is a tiny bit off. I have never played that. If you have, let me know if it's any good. Convoy's on here. That one seemed kind of interesting. Prison Architect is down to $7.50 from $30. Then we have a Telltale a sale going on as well. So, we've seen a lot of these games. You got your Wolf Among Us, Game of Thrones, Tales from the Borderlands, some Batman ones, Walking Dead, of course, Minecraft, Guardians of the Galaxy. Just the full catalog that you see in every sale. And then they have kind of like a horror game type sale going on as well. Is Necrovision the one that's like World War One themed? Yeah, it looks like it. Like this, like World War One, but with vampires and ghosts and zombies and skeletons and stuff. Apparently the best, worst FPS. I would probably enjoy that. I like linear FPSs on occasion. Okay, Vampire the Masquerade. Bloodlines. What is Redemption? I don't even know what that is. This? Why does he have a sword? I don't know if this is older or newer than the other one. I've only seen Bloodlines. Well, it looks like some people like it. It's hard to tell with reviews on here. This actually has a lot of reviews. A lot of games on GOG only have a couple, and they either hate it or love it. Okay, what else? Sunless Sea seemed like an interesting game, but I played it at a friend's house and didn't really get too far, didn't really get it. Amnesia and Soma are on sale. Amnesia the Dark Descent is a great game. The Outlast franchise, all three are on sale. Was the original Alan Wake in this list? The original Alan Wake is better than American Nightmare. Okay. Some of like the weekend sales and things that I called up here in separate tabs. Okami HD, that came out pretty recently, I think, is 30% off. I've always heard this is a really unique and great game, but I've never played it myself. And it has very positive reviews on Steam, but something. But yeah, I've heard good things about both the remake and original game. So that's cool. 60% off The Witcher Wild Hunt Game of the Year edition. So that's down to 20 from the original price of 50. Sid Meier's Civ 6 is down to $30 from 60. So half off there. And this has some mixed reviews. And I got it recently, and my opinions on it are kind of mixed as well. There's some mechanics that I like and I think are cool. It kind of mix things up. Like if you do certain things, it gives you points towards researching that technology. But then I think there's just some gameplay things and usability things that are kind of annoying and don't make sense. Like, I think the ambition system for the AI is a cool idea, but is just too annoying the way it is. Like, the AI will have certain ambitions or like things that'll make them either like you or hate you, and some of them can be pretty unavoidable. Like, your first, I don't know, you start on like a continent, and then there's another civilization you meet that says that their ambition is to own that continent, and they're just immediately mad at you for encroaching on their continent that they want. Or some will just be mad at you for having less troops than they do right when you meet them, and just weird things like that. But as a plus, you do get Sean Bean doing some narration there. You get old Ned Stark. And the, seem to coincide with the DLC that came out. So that's probably not a good sign. Rise and Fall just came out recently. Let's see. Mixed reviews. I saw a lot of negative. Yeah, 66. So I guess it didn't redeem anything. Hefty price tag, $30. This weekend, Chivalry Medieval Warfare is, I can't believe they're still charging $25 normally, but you can get it for $3.74 or a 4-pack for $11. So, there's still a lot of fun to be had in this game. Sometimes, a couple times a year, me and some friends will have a LAN party, and we always play this one and have a lot of fun. There's a Bandai Namco anime sale, so a lot of games here that I've never played. Interested in. I wonder how this one is. And I always thought Dragon Ball Xenoverse looked pretty cool. What is this? A VR MMORPG. Oh, but that's just the setting. I've only seen a few episodes of this back when it was on. So is this game, it can be single player or online, and it looks like an MMO too, so that's kind of interesting. 16 down from 40, that looks like. Some Fallout 4 DLC and Fallout 4 itself all on sale. See more, and I'll see you guys in the next video.